Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Devin Singletary with his first carry of the game. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's a pickup of 17 on that one, and a Bills first down. They had three tight ends in on that set, and they were really good at blocking for their running back.
And give them a lot of credit, because in football nowadays, tight ends coming out of college often don't block very often. These guys have really developed into superior blockers, and that's why they use them in this formation so often.
This will be a Brown sack. The D-tackle, Sheldon Richardson, came barreling in for the sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. Calling no gain there, and it brings forth a third and long. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
On third and long, it's Allen. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Credit the sack to the always disruptive Olivier Vernon.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
Fielded just inside the 20. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
I hope you brought your left, because I'm about to
run.
Switch.
A first carry now for Nick Chubb. Up to make the play defensively, Tre'Davious White.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Alert!
Regular! Rush in! Watch.
They go with Chubb on second down. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of two, now third down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage.
Pistol. Tighten up.
Kings.
49, guys.
On third down, Mayfield. Forced out to his left, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The veteran Jerry Hughes drops the hammer in the backfield. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at the 31-yard line.
General West!
Going to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 16 yards there, and the Bills have a first down. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he's going to take this across the 50 into Browns territory. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. From just shy of midfield, Allen. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Throwing is Allen on third. Flush to his right. And able to find John Brown. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 37.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
On first down, Singletary. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Knox, the tight end, making the catch. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
On third down, they'll run with Gore. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. It's a pickup of 3, but it brings up what will be an interesting 4th and 1. They'll pass up a field goal attempt. It would have been a 45-yarder. Now they'll go for it on 4th. Singletary, they'll run for it. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on 4th. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. On 1st down, they stick with Singletary. Denzel Ward, the number 4 pick in the 2018 draft, making the tackle from his corner spot.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. From the 24, Allen finding Knox there, complete. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 12-yard line. First trip to the red zone for the Bills. It's first and 10 from the 12. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Throwing on second and 8. Allen, it's caught. Smith. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Being chased out left. Complete. Smith has it. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. So the snap will come from the 3, but remember, they don't need the touchdown. They can get the first down if they get a yard and the ball gets to the 2. They'll try and run for it. And he takes it in across the chalk for a Bills touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run as they are now on the board here in the first half.
I don't think it's any state secret to know what they were saying before the start of this drive. Let's go and punch one in the end zone and go into the halftime feeling a heck of a lot better about ourselves. Let's go get this done.
Yeah, tie things up, and then you got a brand new ball game. Hauschka adds the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Gets fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
180. Check the out.
Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Set and ready to go for the second half. 1 touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Cleveland offense ready to go. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter 3.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
All right, T-Lo. Hurry!
Shift, shift! He's coming! We got double up.
Deuce! My pass!
They run it again with Chubb. And he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized.
Good! 180!
49!
Oh, yeah.
Pistol.
Yeah, coming. Hey, Seam six.
49's a mic.
Mayfield from the gun on third down. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball. And we see yet another errant throw as a result.
To return is Roberts. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. It's a loss of a yard there and it's second down.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right, you look at the numbers. Neither side looks on track in the ground game. Now a throw here on second down, and that's complete. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And it looks like a nickel set now for the Browns on third down.
Let's get off the field, D.
Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. He rifles one that's intercepted. Greedy Williams picks it off. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
Good. 180.
Real. It's on field. Hey, it's on route.
Run. My God.
Following the interception, Mayfield. And he's got the hook up to Landry. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Here's Mayfield. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
Regular.
First and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Mayfield on first down. It's caught by OBJ. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Brings up second and three at the 17-yard line.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three.
Check it out, Reed. Check 43.
My touch.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. And they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
A field goal would get him the lead, but that's not what they're shooting for as they come up on third down.
You better be afraid of me.
Throwing, Mayfield. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde, and he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. Well, they thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range, but boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
On first down, they'll start out with Singletary, and he'll get this one up to about his 14. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. So the scoring dried up here in the third. Nothing that quarter for either side. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 9. Allen steps away to his left. He's going to take off with it. And he'll be out of bounds right around the 20. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
They'll try and run for this with Singletary. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. 14 yards, and the Bills will get a new set of downs. Good push up front in that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
They will run with Singletary. The tackle made by Eric Murray.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. And now they'll throw with Allen. He'll let it go deep for Foster. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, but they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down.
Hey, Foxtrot, Foxtrot.
From the gun, it's Allen. Man open, that's Robert Foster complete. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down. So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Eric Murray. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. In a tie game fourth quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations the type of plays they like to run. Read it. And we're able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Singletary to get the drive started. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
From the 31, Allen. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Morgan Burnett. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
On first down, they'll run to Chubb. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Jerry Hughes on the stop. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Whistles now and a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the two-minute warning. And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the two-minute warning. And again, it's Chubb. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
Alert! Mike's 49.
Hey, Delta.
Yeah.
Here's Mayfield. And oh, this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17.
What a catch and one-handed. And I'm starting to lose my awe about the play. And maybe I shouldn't. How much of this is the player? How much of it is the glove?
Well, those gloves, they do have a little grip to them,
don't
they?
They get a little extra tackiness to them now, and I know the guys in the NFL, the competition committee, some other places, they're talking about examining those gloves to see if they're having too much of an effect on the game.
Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. So instead of running, Mayfield's going to throw it here. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down.
Watch the screen. Check nickel. Check 24. Hey, switch gears.
Hey, alert 33. Watch that.
Mayfield to throw. Find Harris, complete. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A big pickup there, and without question, that should be more than enough to wrap this one up. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away.
Check out, bro. Hot.
Real.
Check the backer. Slam. Check. You got tight.
They'll run with Chubb. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. The lone man in the backfield here is Chubb on second and goal. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that'll do it. For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Browns, and they're happy in the dog pound as we say so long from Cleveland.
about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. I score up in the end zone, do my dance all on a hater. A mover and a shaker, you a novice, I'm a player. I'm from DC, but I'm running through and sacking like a raider. Two chains on my neck, one for now and one for later. And we don't play fair, baby, we play for keeps. You can pass me up, this is not a bye week. I'm looking for a trophy competition, looking steep. And I'm training, I've been focused, I've been bombing from the deep. I'm like, move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Championships, all my records go hard, it's a champion hit. I've been working for this moment like I've been in the gym, jumping all over hurdles, I'm evading the pit. Hit to hit with anybody, take them, I can shake them. I invite them to the fire, then I bake them, I'ma break them. I'm a Hall of Fame legend, they should go and hang my jersey. Made to put in work, I don't think they really heard me like. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. Ain't no stopping me, ain't no topping me, I am up. Number one seed, ain't nobody popping up. Got a squad of gorillas from the jungle suited up. You kicking off against me, hope you ready, get it up. I be booted up, popping out a sprinter or a truck. Whole team chasing bags while they chasing us. Call an audible, I read the game, I think it's time to switch. You get hit, if I miss, then my teammates got the blitz, yeah. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains.
One of them got my back.